Alankaras are accepted by Anandavardhana in his Dhunyaloka. As actually Ruyyaka is following the path of that, these Alankaras also accepted, it should be considered as he is also Dhvanivadi. By keeping such attitude in his mind, he wrote Alankarasarvasva. There are eight sutras or aphorisms as recorded in Alankarasarvasva. From the beginning, particularly in prelude or preface, Ruyyaka explained the different doctrines or previous scholars or acharyas. In connection to the soul of poetry or kabya, he has summarized the opinion of Bhamaha, Udvatta, Rudrata, Bhamana, Kuntaka, Mahimabhatta and Anandavardhanacharya. After explaining all, finally he has accepted the opinion of Anandavardhana of Dhvanivada. While writing Alankarasarvasva, Rajanaka Ruyyaka has followed the style of ancient Alankarikas, as the Lakshana will be given first. Again actually Vritti and Udaharanas. The same manner, the same portfolio has maintained in works of Alankarasarvasva. First each and every Alankaras, later the Lakshanas are written in a sutra form, and thereafter Vrittis and their explanation or Vyakhya in different mode. Starting from the Acharya Bharata to Acharya Mammata, scholars have recorded 118 Alankaras, whereas Ruyyaka has accepted only 75 by rejecting 43 Alankaras. This is not to be accepted. Upama we are telling, they are telling actually Sadrusya Vichiti, the section of similarity. So no need to have many more things. If you include in one direction, in one table, 10 Alankaras are coming in that category. Like that, and he has explained in that way. In respect to the definition of earlier rhetoricians, the definition of Ruyyaka sometimes are varying or differ to each other. Apart from this, Ruyyaka also introduced 7 new Alankaras as his own. Therefore, the total number of Alankaras as per Rajanaka Ruyyaka is 82. A beautiful chart is prepared by Reva Prasad Divedi in his commentary. This is actually Graha Alankaraha, Dandi, Bhamaha, Bhamana, Bhoja, Rudrata. These are the Alankaras as actually Dandi accepted, but Ruyyaka is not accepting that one. This is Agraha, it is not to be accepted that. And thereafter, Graha Alankaraha, prominent Alankaras actually he has chosen it, and classification actually has made in that way. Next Raja. Graha Alankaraha, these are the Alankaras prominently Swabhavakti, Upama, Rupaka, Deepaka, Akshepa, Arthantra Nyasa, Vyatireka, like this. It is going on in proper way, where Dandi has accepted this and Ruyyaka is also going to accept that. And the first pages which has written earlier, this is not accepted by Acharya Ruyyaka. Bhamaha, Udvatta, Bhamana, Rudrata, and moreover actually I can say here Utpriksha Alankara, you see, Dandi has given Utpriksha Alankara, Ruyyaka is also accepting that. But Bhamaha Utpriksha is not accepted by Ruyyaka. Little changes is there in that, where actually he feel actual discomfort, it is not to be properly explained and he has omitted it. Then third one is Swakalpita Alankaraha, actually self-established Alankaras like Parinama Alankaraha, Ullekha Alankaraha, Vichitram, Vikalpaha, Bhavodayaha, Bhavasandhi, Bhavasabalata. As I said, Ete Pruthak Alankaraha. By explaining that section, again actually he is highlighting here the definition and Udaharan is not so sufficient. At least more explanation is required. That's why he has taken specific place at least to explain more. The beauty of the works of Alankarasarvasva is its classification. While explaining the Alankaras, Ruyyaka has followed the unique method to write the Alankaras by classifying the whole content in the text into sections called as Suddhakhanda and Mishrakhanda. Suddhakhandas are, it is coming actually Sabdalankara Varga, and they are actually Arthapaunarukti, Vyanjana, Swastha, Vyanjana Buruti, Sabdartha, Uhayapta Khetre, Sthana Vishesha Khetre. all these five sections are taken actually as Shuddhakanda, coming to the category of Shabdalankara Varga. And Arthalankara Varga has actually number of list has given there, where a small heading has made at sub chapters, actually sub section has made by Ruyyaka, Sadrusya Vichiti. As I said, Vichiti Nama Bhaga, you can say, section, where actually similarity occurs, the sections are coming under this category. Where Bheda Bheda Tulya Tvena, Abheda Pradhanya Tvena, Gamya Aupamya Tvena, Bheda Pradhanya Tvena, Visheshana Vicharatvena, Gamyarthata Vichiti Tena, Birodha Vichiti Tvena, Ekaheva Alankartha Birodha Hiti. Evam Kathitva Tatriva Virodha Khetre, under the section of Virodha Vichiti, Suddha Virodha, Karyakarana Bhava Vistrita Virodha, Astraya Astrita Virodha, Vyatihara Mulaka Virodha, which actually not at all explained by any other, I mean, Alankarikas of earlier one, where Ruyyaka has actually vividly explained on this to give specific justice to the particular Alankaras. Again, it is coming Srinkhala Vichyuti, the connectivity, like Anuprasa, Yamaka, Srinkhala Vichyuti. They are actually telling Mala Deepakam, Deepakadi Alankaranam Tatracharcha. Eighth one is Nyaya Vichyuti, Nyaya section. As you say, Kabyalinga Alankara, all the Alankarikas are telling Kabyalinga Alankaras. Very beautifully, actually, Ruyyaka has made it as Linga Alankara, Hetu Alankara. In changing the term as Kabyalinga, Ruyyaka has given us Hetu Alankara, reason. Tarkanyaya Alankara, Bakyanyaya Alankara to another section Bhavati, Lokanyaya Alankara. All these sections are coming under Nyaya Vichyati, Gudartha Parata Vichyati section under this, Suddha, Sputarthata, and Brutta Brutyasritaha. Up to this, it is coming under this Suddha section, and Mishra section, it is coming under two prominent Alankaras like Samsrishti, and there also subcategories has made Sabda Alankara Samsrishti, Artha Alankara Samsrishti, and Uhe Alankara, Sabda Artha Uhe Alankara Samsrishti, and Sankar is separately explained by Ruyyaka. So this is a brief outlook of this whole text of Alankara Sarvasva. Coming to the part of the tikas, where actually many more information can be gathered on the text of Alankara Sarvasva. The Karikakaras and the Vrittikaras of Alankara Sarvasva, it is unanimously accepted that Acharya Ruyyaka is the writer of Alankara Sarvasva. The text Alankara Sarvasva is divided into three parts, such as Sutra. As I said, 88 Sutras are explained, thereafter Vrittis and Udaharanas. And inclusion of all, it is termed as Alankara Sarvasva. The Sutra parts is known as Alankara Sutras, and other two parts are known as Alankara Sarvasva. Hence, we must say, there is no doubt about the Acharya Ruyyaka, the author of Alankara Sarvasva, Alankara Sutra, but in connection to the Vrutti part, we have some sorts of confusion. Some scholars have opined that Vrutti part is written by Acharya Ruyyaka simultaneously, but other critics used to say Mankha, the Mankhaka, the two different name also, is the author of Vrittis. Such confusion occurs in Mangalacharan of itself as its reason. In North India edition published by Kabyamala series with the Mimarsinit commentary of Jayaratha, it is made Namaskrityam Paravacham Devim Trividhavigraham Nijalankara Sutranam Vrittyam Tatpariyam Uchyate. That Nijalankaraha, myself established Alankaras, the sutras, I am explaining. It is the first explanation of Northern edition. Whereas, in this Mangalacharanam, the term is Alankara Sutranam, the Alankaras, the sutras which was established by myself, and I am explaining on, denotes that the meaning of Alankara Sutras is made by author himself, and again, he himself wrote the commentary on sutras. But in South Indian edition, published by Trivandrum series, in Samudrabandha Tika, it differs from the first one. It said, Namaskrityam Parabacham Devim Trividhavigraham Gurvarankara Sutranam Vrutyam Tatvaryam Uchyate. Tatparya Sahityam Tavat Gurucharanam Kathitanam Sutranam Vyakshamaya Kriyate. The sutras which has made by my teacher, my preceptor, I am doing that. As if Ruyaki himself is not doing, his preceptor, his disciple, Mankaka is doing that. But thereafter, critics used to give different opinion and conclude that this is not to be considered as Mankaka is the writer of Alankara Sarvasva, Ruyaki is the writer of Alankara Sarvasva, where Guru, the term itself is in different way to be understood. It is not the sutras of my teacher, the sutras which are having prominent weightage, that sutras actually I am explaining it. As if the writer himself says that sutras are not so easy at least to understand in a general way. That has to be explained by me. It has its potentiality at least to explain. Guru, Guru Nama Vaitas, or the prominent one. Here it is understood that Vruttikaras is entirely different from Sutrakaras. This is the second version, as I said. The term Guru Alankara Sutranam refers to Alankara Sutras are made by the Guru, the preceptor, whereas the Vruttis are made by Sishya, as referred by the critics, that Mankaka is the disciple of Ruyaka, like that, as I said. Hence, it may say that Vruttis are written by Mankaka, not by Rajanaka Ruyyaka. The explanation already I have given. Finally, actually, we have to conclude that Ruyyaka has written this Alankara Sarvasva, no doubt at all. Apart from this, we may come across with two different manuscripts written in Sarada scripts, which is available in present Pune, the Deccan College of Manuscript Bori, that library, where it is clearly mentioned that Ruyaka is the author of Alankara Sarvasva, as it is said. Samapitam idam Alankara Sarvasvam iti Sreyah Krutistatra Bhagavad Rajanakaha Ruyaka Syeti. This is the first version. Second one, Sampurna idam Alankara Sarvasvam iti Sreyo Bhavatu Lekhaka Pathakayoho Kruti Rajanaka Tatra Truti Vartate Tankarajanita dosaha vartante ruyakah seti. Therefore, we may conclude that Rajanaka Ruyaka is the author of Alankara Sarvasva. Most probably, this his disciple Mankaka might have edited or corrected the text after Ruyaka. The commentaries on Alankara Sarvasva. After deep observation, it is clear that there are four commentaries available as so far on Alankara Sarvasva. Rajanaka Alaka, his commentary is Sarvasva Tika. In Kabya Prakasa Tika of Ratnakantha, it is clearly said that Rajanaka Alaka is the commentator of Alankara Sarvasva. The exact reference is also available in Sruti Kaustubha Anjali. Dr. V. Raghavan also mentioned that Rajanaka Alaka is the commentator of Alankara Sarvasva. In his text, Srungara Prakasa of Bhoja, in the commentary, that in preface itself, in page number 380, I have noted it. Unfortunately, the commentary of Rajanaka Alaka is not available at present. People are claiming that it is available in Pune, but I contacted the organization of Pune, but they got the information that this text is not available with us. Anyway, some critics says that Alaka is Bishama Padabdhyoti Tika, and where some says he is the writer of 10th Ullasas of Kabya Prakasa. As we say, it is actually incomplete one, and Alaka might have completed that. Some says he is the guru of Kallana, as popularly known as Sandhi Vigrahaka Alaka Datta. And the date of Rajanaka Alaka may be fixed in the first part of the 12th century, as per this critic says. Jayaratha, Vimarshini Tika. Among the different commentaries on Alankarasarvasva, Vimarshini Tika of Jayaratha is so popular, authentic, and intellectually a high product of literary work. It is also said that by following the text of Alankarasarvasva with its example, Pandita Jayaratha has written this commentary for easy understanding of his grandchild during his old age. The critic says, Alankarasarvasva was so popular by the meantime, where it was taught like, to make the beauty of works, to enjoy the beauty of works, and teacher was actually explaining his grandchild the sutras and the bhakyas and the udaharanas of Alankarasarvasva. It is said, Pratigya matreva vetat upekshikam vichakshanehi alankar vibarsinyaha yuktirukta charatracha. Sangatam muddhisyam nijam atra truti vartate satyam api balye srutarthitam pautram balyarthe balye srutarthinam pautram meva bodhayati akhila nikhilan alankaran kruti siddhantam alanka kruti alankruti siddhantam jayarathaha sputartha padam. This is the Alankar Mimamsa text, where actually these two quotation actually you can get it. And it is also clear that at the end of this commentary work, the writer himself has given the complete details of his own. Samudra Bandha, that is Vritti Tika, Vibhruti Tika, you can say, or Vritti Tika. Alankara Sarvasva of Samudra Bandha got proper name and fame in South India. Also, as the writer was the court poet of Ravi Varman, the king of Colombo, the present Kerala, or as we say, Malabar, and whose time was middle part of the 13th century. In prelude, the writer has explained the definition of kabyas as visishto arthat savadartho kabyam. The word and its meaning, when actually it differs, when it confers the excellent meaning that should be called as kabyas. It is also understood that writer has followed the style of Mammata's Kabya Prakasa and given his own example for easy understanding. The fourth one is Sri Vidya Chakrabarti. Critics used to say that Chakrabarti is the prominent writer of this tika, and Sri Vidya, that will be the designation, has offered to him later on because he was also Vedantist. Sanjeevani Tika. Sri Vidya Chakrabarti was a great scholar, having command over the different sastras like Saiva, Vaishnava, Vedanta, Sankhya, Purana, and Natya also. And he was the court poet of King Billana III, and his time may be fixed in the first part of the 14th century. Apart from this, Sanjeevani Tika, he also wrote two different tikas on Kabya Prakasa of Mammata, such as Bhrat Tika and Laghu Tika. A manuscript by name Rukmini Kalyanam, which written by him, and it is also presently available. This is the brief description on the commentaries of Alankara Sarvasva. At the end, we may conclude that the Alankara Sarvasva for Rajanaka Ruyyaka is the milestone for the scholars, for new generation, to understand the Alankara Sastras. It will extend an opportunities and the privilege to realize the growth and development of Alankara Sastras, starting from Bhamaha, Dandi, Udvatta, Bhamana, Mammata, up to Pandit Raja Jagannatha. Thank you all. Okay, that will be also. Yeah, both are same. Yeah.
Any questions? have died. Any question, Basmati?
They're actually first part.
Yeah.
Yeah. When Arthapatti actually is explained, he has taken actually the ideas of Mamata.
Yeah. And he has taken actually ideas of Mammatas. And when actually he was explaining actually Arthapatti actually his own way, it differs from part of Mammata and taking into consideration of present way of explanation. As we say, the Nyaya concept we can say, Parvato Bannimanaya. In Linga, Hetu that will be made as it is. Wherever fire, there will be definitely smoke. So that will be Kabya Linga, Hetu. There will be fire, opposite in that way. That will be Hetu Alankara. And same way Arthapati has taken it that way. As I understood like this.
Even though actually Atishyokti also, three different way actually they have explained, three different way. It may not be saying that actually this will be the exact one.
That is why he is not accepting it.
But he has not taken actually proper attention to ask that.
Yes.
Himself, it is actually own one. Yeah. Completely independence he has taken there. He has not followed the previous one.
Any more questions? Any more?
Being a professor of Alankara Shastra, he has made a thorough study of the history of Alankara Shastra and also the place where Ruyyaka is placed by fate very beautifully in between the Dwani school and later schools. He correctly pointed out that Alankara Sarvasva plays a very important role because all the other theories come only after him, based on Ruyyaka's work. More than Ruyyaka, his commentator Vimarsinikara gets more attention by Jagannatha Pandita. Jagannatha Pandita will often quote Vimarsinikara everywhere with respect. He almost follows him very truthfully, strictly, and appreciates him. Then that is a very great thing for his professor Ruyyaka. The student, the commentator has been appreciated a lot. By and by, Ruyyaka also will be brought in by Jagannatha in his explanations. Very interesting how the theory of Alankara Shastra has developed throughout the ages without any deterrent. Even though maybe somebody is adding some Alankara, we do not know, they have not come into vogue. Till Appaya Dikshita, after him, Alankara Manihara, Alankara Kaustubha, so many texts, and they have been adding and adding. Sometimes it looks like hair-splitting divisions, but they are beautiful. For instance, the most insignificant division, Vishadana Alankara, which only Kavaliyanandakara gives, the verse is so beautiful. Everybody knows probably, Ratrir Gamishyati, Hasishyati Pankajasrihi, Ratrir Gamishyati, Bhavishyati Suprabhatam, Baswanudeshyati, Hasishyati Pankajasrihi, Ittam Vichintayati Koshagate Dvirepe, Ha Hanta Hanta, Nalinim Gaja Ujjahara. It's a beautiful verse, but people will not take it to Uttama Kavya, they will consider it only as Madhyama Kavya. It's a, in four lines, the hope of the bee that has got into the lotus which has closed itself because of the sunset, and its loss of hope when the elephant tramples on it. When the words ha hanta hanta is said, you really feel that the bee is getting trampled under the feet of the elephant. Such beautiful thing. It is a small alankara, very insignificant, which others have not made note of. Like that, here also Ruyyaka gives some very simple alankaras. His list has been given there. Bhavika, but Bhavika, Dr. Raghavan treats it in a big essay on Bhavika. And Urjasvi, Rasavat, Prayas. These are very simple alankaras, but they have beautiful definitions and examples which make you enjoy the definition. Actually, the examples make you enjoy the definition more than the definition itself. The Lakshana is only for the already existing Kavya, so the Lakshana is as per that. The enjoyment of Kavya had been their forte. They have really enjoyed life, they have really enjoyed literature, and they have brought such theories into vogue which we are able to now understand, to enhance our understanding of the world. This actually helps us in understanding the world, seeing so many things. Dr. Janaki would say, when she went to UK for her PhD, they would not understand what Upama and Rupaka is. They cannot understand comparing the face to the moon or to the lotus. So she would say it is very difficult, it is a very different atmosphere altogether for them to understand this. We are also like that. We are far removed from Indian culture today, being taught by the Western ways, that when we read all these things, we are able to appreciate our own niceties and inner feelings that respond to this poetry. Thank you, sir, for a very nice presentation. You have traced the history, placed Ruyyaka properly between the two different worlds altogether. His vyakhyas and how they have interpreted him, and how well he had been respected, and all these have been brought out very well. We thank you for your well-prepared lecture, and I would like him to give it as a paper to our Journal of Oriental Research, where we could publish it with more details. I thank everyone who have come here for this, especially Dr. Janaki's brother. And before we close the day, we are offering some of our publications. I request our secretary to offer them to the speaker. Three publications. One is Kuppuswami Shastri Memorial Volume. No. Highways and Byways. Yeah, Highways and Byways. You will enjoy it, sir. The second is by Dr. Raghavan, Concept of the Beauty. And the third is Chaturyuga Calendar, which is our project that we have done, which we think will break ice with the history of India. I thank you once again for the fine lecture. I thank everybody for being here. Next week we are having a lecture on Vasu, next week paper by Dr. Narasimhan on Ramanuja and Alvars, a comparative study, impact of Alvars on Ramanuja. It is Narasimhacharya Endowment. Kindly make it convenient to attend the lecture. Thank you all. Very good, sir. Thank you. Clearly, you should give us a paper. Yeah. But add more of Ruyyaka. Yes.